Anthony Grasso here, bringing you financial news you can use. In this video, I'm going to do a stock analysis on Transenterix. I'm going to go over a summary of the company, its product offerings, recent headline news, financials, analyst projections, and give it my buy, hold, or sell recommendation. So let's get right into it. So the company designs, develops, and manufactures medical devices. It offers spider surgical system, a laparoscopic surgical platform that allows intra-abdominal triangulation to be performed with articulating instruments through a single site. Now, the company is primarily focused on the development and commercialization of SurgiBot, which is a patient-side, minimally invasive surgical robotic system. The company was formerly known as SafeStitch Medical Incorporated, and it's based in the United States. Now, upcoming clinical milestones and regulatory approvals are set to support accelerating growth opportunities for this company. Now, let's note that it is still in the early stages of commercialization. Its enhanced surgical robotic system, the platform introduces several pioneering functions and capabilities, representing a differentiation compared to the alternatives that are on the marketplace. Now, the company does note that Senhance is the first robotic system with artificial intelligence and machine vision capabilities incorporating proprietary software technology. Now, Senhance also is the first to use a haptic feedback control for the practicing surgeon, while it believes it offers superior precision relative to the hand movements of other platform use. Now, as it relates to laparoscopy, surgeons will likely feel comfortable as the system uses the familiar seated position enhanced with a 3D visualization, including the eye tracking technology and remote type controls. Any discussion of robotic surgery needs to include the Intuitive Surgical Incorporation, which is the market leading Da Vinci robotic assisted surgery system. Now, several aspects make Senhance different and potentially a superior product, though. Again, the seat console positioning of Senhance is ideal for laparoscopic surgery, while the Da Vinci may be more appropriate for other applications. In this regards, the Senhance isn't necessarily attempting to replace Da Vinci for all types of operations, but instead, it offers a more specialized solution with alternative technique. The company does highlight, though, a large and fast-growing market for surgical robots, with laparoscopic robotic surgery representing a significant green pasture opportunity in the future. The company estimates that the $3.7 billion abdominal robotic surgery market in 2018 may grow by about four times through 2023 to $16 billion. That's kind of huge. Now let's go look at some news. So yesterday it was announced that Transenterix received the CE mark for machine vision system in robotic surgery. Now, it's important to note that this approval will provide Senhance digital laparoscopic programs in Europe access to this new technology, which is a new revenue stream, ushering them to the forefront of surgical innovation utilizing augmented intelligence. And five days ago, it was announced that they closed the $31.25 million registered direct offering of common stock. Now, this announcement of the closing, it was previously announced of the registered direct offering of 25 million shares of its common stock. The offering was priced at a purchase price of $1.25 a share for gross proceeds of approximately $31.25 million. Now, Transenterix intends to use the net proceeds from the offering for general corporate purposes, including working capital. Now, this is something to note that the working capital is extremely important for a company invested heavily in its research and development to get their products out there, because this company basically has negative cash flows, and we'll get into that. So let's go ahead and look at some of the fundamentals of the company. The current market capitalization of the company is $577 million with a current stock price of $3.85 a share. Revenues over the past years have been rocky at best. Going from 2012 to $2.12 million, declining to nothing in 2015, then skyrocketing to $24 million in 2018 and declining back down to $8.53 million in 2019. The earnings in 2020 will be reported around March 16, 2021, and it's expected to have negative 57 cents a share, which is more positive than the 2018 earnings, which were about negative, or 2019 earnings, where they were negative $4.22 a share. On positive news about its revenues, revenue is forecasted to grow about 99.3% per year going into the future. The company is overvalued based on its price to book ratio of 5.6 times compared to the US medical industry average of 5.1 times. Now, there are some risk factors to consider. This is a highly volatile share stock with share price over the past 3 months. Shareholders have been substantially diluted in the past year. I just showed you that news article just a few days ago. And it's currently unprofitable and not forecasted to become profitable over the next 3 years. It does not have any meaningful revenue at the moment. It's only about $3.11 million approximately by the end of 2020. We'll see exact numbers when those numbers come out. It is more volatile than 90% of U.S. stocks over the past 3 months, typically moving a plus or minus 32% a week. Its weekly volatility has increased 26 to 32% over the past year. Now, definitely on those are the negative points. Now, let's look at some good points. Earnings are forecasted to grow by an average of 9% per year over the next 3 years. It did exceed the U.S. medical equipment industry average, which returned 20% over the past year, and has exceeded the U.S. market, which returned about 19.5% over the past year. But its projected revenue are only $3.11 million by the end of 2020, with negative $59 million projected earnings. So it's definitely in the red, and it's going to be in the red for a few years. By the end of 2022, it is projected to have $25 million in revenue with negative $47 million in earnings. It is important to note that the ownership breakdown is 0.9% private companies, 1.4% individual insiders, 17.3% institutions, and the general public, get this, own a whopping 80.4%. Now let's go ahead and look at some milestones for the company. Several regulatory milestones are on track for the first half of 2021 and are set to support the continued growth opportunities. The company is expected to receive the CE mark in Europe for the intelligent surgical unit, the ISU, which adds real-time augmented intelligence capabilities to the robotics platform. In the United States, the company expects to receive FDA 510K pre-market notification, which essentially legalizes the use by recognizing its safety for expanded use of the Senhance system for general surgical indication. The company also is filing for an additional FDA 510K request with the next generation technologies. There are also expectations for peer-reviewed publications to highlight the clinical effectiveness and performance of the Senhance this year. Another growth driver is set to be in the pediatrics usage in Europe. So there's definitely light at the end of the horizon for this company. So let's examine what the exact the Wall Street analysts say about this company right now. The overall consensus from Wall Street is a hold right now. One analyst is a strong buy, two analysts are a hold, and one analyst is a sell, a strong sell. And am I a buy, hold, or sell recommendation on this company? Here are my thoughts. There are a few notable weaknesses which I believe should have a greater impact than any strengths, and could make it more difficult for investors to achieve positive results compared to the most of the stocks that I cover. Among the areas I feel are negative, one of the most important has been the poor profit margin. The gross profit margin for this company is currently lower than what is desirable, coming in at 30.01%. Now, despite the mixed results of the gross profit margin, the company's net profit margin is negative 1,855%, significantly underperformed when compared to the subsector average. The company's return on equity is greatly increased when compared to its return on equity from the same quarter 1 year prior. That is a signal of significant strength within the corporation, which is definitely good news. Compared to other companies in the miscellaneous manufacturing subsector and the overall market, the company's return on equity significantly trails that both of the subsector average and the S&P 500 in general. Now, the company reported significant earnings per share improvement in the most recent quarter, and that's definitely a positive thing compared to the same quarter a year ago. The company has not demonstrated a clear trend in earnings over the past 2 years. It's actually just been all over the place, making it difficult to accurately predict earnings in the coming year. I mean, they're all over the place. How can you predict that? During the past fiscal year, the company reported poor results of negative $8.88 versus a negative $3.90 in the prior year. The company with its weak revenue results has greatly underperformed against the subsector average of 1.3%. The company, though, has a solid balance sheet. Now, the debt to equity ratio is low at 0.05, and it's currently below that of the subsector average, implying that there has been very successful management of debt levels. To add to this, the company has a quick ratio of 1.8, and that demonstrates the ability of the company to cover its short-term liquidity needs. Definitely a great thing. Since the same quarter 1 year prior, revenues plummeted 59.8%. The declining revenue has not hurt the company, though, which is with its bottom line, which is surprising with this increased earnings per share. Now, the price to sales and the price to book ratios, I feel, are one of the most appropriate valuation measures of this company. Therefore, the company seems highly valued with a price to sales ratio of 150.97 times. That is one of the highest in the healthcare equipment and supplies industry. However, their price to book ratio is only 5.61 times. That is in line with the industry median of around 4.87 times. So I think of all these fundamentals as the house in Vegas. Betting against the house can bring huge windfalls, but remember, the house usually always wins in the long run. So therefore, based upon all of this information, I am a strong sell on this company based on its current market price of $3.80 a share right now. I believe the catalyst for the recent rally may have been related to the series of industry investor conferences the company has participated in over the past several months, which has helped raise visibility for this investment opportunity. So let me use this analogy. There are 80% of shares owned by the general public of this company. And what you're seeing right now is what I call the herd mentality, rushing at this stock. And when the herd disappears and all is left with destruction to the lands underneath your feet. Yes, I do know that this is oversimplifying this, but hey, if the shoe fits, right? I will keep this definitely on my watch list. If you like the company, my strategy would be to target this stock price around the dollar to the $1.50 a share because of the human factor involved in this over the next year. That probably won't get down to what a reasonable price point would be of about 90 cents a share to $1.25 a share. I would hold for the long term, which might be risky bet if you have a high, you must have a very high pain risk tolerance for this. I would definitely not buy it at the current price. Now let's explain the bullish case. Okay, so I'm a bear on this stock right now, but I'm a bull long term. I do love the company. I do think it's going to be great in the future, just not right now. I just keep it on my watch list. So the bullish case for this company is that the Senhance robotic surgery system, it will become the industry standard, the market standard for laparoscopy, driving a wave of global adoption. That's a bullish case. I mean, global adoption of the technology. You're betting for that if you think this is going to happen. With that said, there are many uncertainties here, and it will be very important for the company to prove that it can execute on the commercialization prospects by demonstrating clear revenue growth with a pipeline of new orders. And that's very important to note. Over the past 8 years, they've been all over the place. Maybe hire a new sales director and figure out what's going on there. This is what I sense. There's some possibility associated with this company as a potentially attractive buyout opportunity from a larger healthcare sector and medical device market leader looking to enter this segment. That would be huge for the stock price if that would happen, and it would jump up drastically. Now, the risk here is that the company fails to find sufficient commercialization opportunities for the Senhance system, liming the long-term outlook. I expect shares to remain volatile, which could drive a sharp correction in the future results disappointment. Larger competitors in the field, including Intuitive Surgical, which could also introduce an alternative laparoscopy robotic surgical solution, limiting the market opportunity for the company. Now, if you're definitely a day trader, this would definitely be the one you might want to include on your watch list, as well as the profit off the massive price swings in the short term. But please tell me your thoughts on this stock in the comments down below. I definitely want to hear what your thoughts are on it. Are you a buy, hold, or sell position on this company? I would love to hear your opinion. Now, there you have it, folks. Now, don't forget to smash that like button down below and consider subscribing to hear financial news that can benefit you. Until the next stock update later today, ciao.